my koti koti dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad, Sri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. And same koti koti dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my Siksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad, Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedant Swami Maharaj.
How he was obeying his master, spiritual master. One day he took a box that Prabhupada used to give to all. Giving lock, the key he used to keep with him. And there was some hole. So,
like a small pie, two pie,
they used to collect. One day Prabhupada was going on car and in Calcutta.
Hot summer day.
Very summer day in a banyan tree. He was sleeping, giving his box
under his head like a pillow.
As a pillow.
The naam can, if he put here, then someone can take, naam can take.
The driver of Prabhupada, any brahmachari, told, oh,
Pyari Mohan,
oh, Sri Brahmanand Bihari is sleeping here. Then tears came in the eyes of Prabhupada. How their high aristocratic family of boy and serving in this back to door to door his begging. By his mercy, oh, now Guru Maharaj is known to whole world. From me and Swamiji, your Gurudev, as he told, with two hands preaching in whole world his mission, teachings, that we are soul. We are not this physical body. Try to understand. This is a bag of urine, stool,
mucus,
blood, urine and everything. One day you will have to give up this body. You will be old. All will neglect you. And you will have to give up this body. In world, no one is happy. Those who are entangled in sense gratifications. So, at once give up all these things. All attachment you should give up and chant Hari name. Hari name is very powerful. It can stop your endless pain of birth and death. Don't delay. Tomorrow you can die. So today you should be engaged. This is the love and affection for Krishna, the Supreme Lord. It will save you. So, they are teaching these things. Prabhupada, in his eyes tears came and he was very much happy. That for me, these landlords, very sukumar,
very soft,
and their whole day in summer day, they are doing like this. And that is why by his mercy, oh, he is now known in whole world. He was, after Prabhupada's departure, he went to Calcutta and established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. Your Gurudev, the Bhakti, Abhayacharan Bhakti Vedanta Swami, at that time Grihastha. He was one of them, founder, and other so many. And he kept this name Bhakti Vedanta. Someone asked, why Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti? Then he told, Prabhupada has kept the name of Abhayacharana Prabhu Bhakti Vedanta. So we preach Brahma Sutra Vyasadeva, that Krishna has form, he has all quality. He is not nirvishesh Brahma, not shapeless, no qualities. So not this. So I have named this samiti Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, and I will give my disciples sannyas
title
Bhakti Vedanta Swami, Bhakti Vedanta Narayan, Bhakti Vedanta Vikram, and like so. So all became satisfied. Then he established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti in Navadvip. Also he preached a center. And Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, giving so much inspiration in dream that still you are not taking sannyas. At once you should accept sannyas, though I have given internally you sannyas. But three times I tried to give you sannyas, but
the management of Gaudiya Math.
For the management, all devotees told that if he will take sannyas, then all management will be ruined. So I stopped. But now you must take. Then he went to Katwa and took sannyas from Param Pujyapad Sridhar Maharaj. Also he was friend of Bhakti Vedanta also. Took sannyas. And then he began to preach all over India, especially Assam, Bengal, and other provinces. Then he gave sannyas, first sannyas, to Pujyapad Vaman Maharaj, the Vikram Maharaj, and myself. And after some days,
59.
Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. He took sannyas. How? In boyhood he was very intelligent, short memory. And he studied in English.
English.
So he was master of English. One day he heard the name of Prabhupada and went to take darshan. And then Prabhupada saw him and at once he told, you are very learned person. You should preach my mission in English.
Western country.
And then he began to write essays in English, Bengali, in Hindi and other things. He used to also give essays to my Gurudev, articles to be published in
monthly
magazine
Gaudiya Patrika.
And also I was editor of Bhagavat Patrika in that.
Indeed.
At that time your Gurudev Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj told me a story that I was manager of
Bengal Chemical
factory.
Medical.
After some time, I opened a new factory, but I failed. And then, in Allahabad, I established a very big shop of medicine, and I used to make medicine myself also by formula, but after some time it also fell. I was thinking that perhaps in Bhagavat it has been written that those who take shelter of Krishna mercifully
them.
What takes is all
Belongings.
Sampati.
Material assets.
Material
assets.
Assets. Everything. And make them street beggar. I was fearing from this slope, but I was not giving up chanting and
remembering,
doing services of Krishna. But I'm seeing that it happened.
You're taking everything from me.
Now I came to Mathura. I was penniless. And he was selling some products himself, medicines. I saw him in Mathura. What are you doing, Prabhu? You should come with me in my temple. And forcibly I took his all luggages and brought him in my Mathura Mat, Keshavji Gauriya Mat. I gave her room. And then, he stopped everything and he told that story. Then I told him that you are very, very intelligent and you are a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. And he had told you to preach in English. So I think it will be better that you should take at once sannyas. Guru Maharaj, our coming to Mathura from Navadvip, very good occasion, you should take sannyas. Then in the meantime Guru Maharaj came and I told also, requested my Gurudev that forcibly you should tell him to take sannyas. And then, anyhow,
Vishwarup Mahotsav. Vishwarup Mahotsav.
On Vishwarup Mahotsav day in Keshavji Gauriya Mat, I made her his danda, his clothing, and I taught him to
how to use all this.
And Guru Maharaj gave him
sannyas.
Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, by doing kirtan.
Muni Maharaj.
Guru Maharaj also in the
years.
Age of
90,
he took sannyas with him. He told that if you are taking sannyas, then I must take sannyas. And both they took. And after that, he began to preach. He went to Jhansi to establish math. But there was some litigation. So he left it and then he came to Delhi, and from Delhi he anyhow settled with Sindhya Navigation, that he wanted to go to America.
From Bombay.
And then for New Jersey he went there.
Boston.
Without any
money.
So, and preached here.
He brought Mahaprabhu Vigraha.
He brought Vigra from Jhansi and it is now established in Mathura Keshavji
from that time.
Guru Maharaj was so bold that if anyone will criticize his Gurudev, at once he will stop his once Nimbark Sampradaya from Vrindavan. They criticized Prabhupada. And then he told Guru Maharaj, take paper and pen. And I too. And he dictated. Nimbark.
There is no
only name, no person. Anywhere it is not written about Nimbark. So he is a Jali Purush.
Forgy.
Imagination.
Actually he was not. Only some his disciple. Any disciple of, they established Nimbarka and then by his name they had done something. Really he was not. And hearing this, they became very furious and they went to start a court case. But advocates told them, advise, don't do, otherwise he's
very bold and
very intelligent.
Very
like
lawyer.
He knows all laws. Then they stop. Also, once some Sahajiya criticized Prabhupada. He don't know rasa, bhakti rasa. Only he's
chewing of mango.
He's sucking the mango seed.
Mango seed.
Now
without
rasa.
That is, he established only tattva, siddhant, no bhakti rasa of conjugal. Then Guru Maharaj at once opposed and gave argument and so strong
argument
against them that they went to court and they did a court case of 1 lakh rupees for
prestige hamper.
But Guru Maharaj kept a very good
lawyer Bhukai,
and he told that I will prove. Then they were subsided and they began to
ask forgiveness.
And then Guru Maharaj told that you should take off your case. And thus, so he was sold. He established mutt in so many places of India and in Bengal, especially Assam. And thus he preached all over the world. Go,
Premanande.